band portion of the 2022 All Hermiston School District Secondary Music Festival. My name is Trisha Mooney. I'm the superintendent of the Hermiston School District, and I will be your MC for this evening's event. Before we get started this evening, I would like to ask you to please silence your cell phones. Our students have worked very hard to prepare for this event. Let's show them our appreciation by being an engaged audience. If you would like to take photos or video of your child on your phone, that is fine. Just please check to make sure it's on airplane mode so the ring won't interrupt the show. Also, if you have little ones, please make sure they stay seated close to you during this evening's performance. Thank you for your attendance at this event. The teachers and students alike appreciate your support of the hundreds of students that you will see and hear tonight. To start things off this evening, please rise and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem by Hermiston High School band students Carter Merritt, Jacob Culligan, Kathy Cordia, Everett Wicks, and Keegan Kellison.
Self-confidence, teamwork, and risk-taking.
We are pleased to have so many students enrolled in musical ensembles within the Hermiston School District and are excited to show off all their hard work. The band programs in the Hermiston School District also involve hundreds of students from 6th to 12th grade as they learn how to play various instruments that you will see in front of you. It takes a lot of hard work to become a competent musical or instrumental musician. When students start band in 6th grade, they not only have to memorize fingerings and learn how to read music, they also must practice meticulously in order to coordinate multiple body parts at the same time and learn to blend in with other musicians in their ensemble. In addition to playing their instruments, these students are also constantly listening to ensure that they are playing in tune, in time, and with proper blend and balance with their bandmates. Band students are required to multitask from day one, which is one of the numerous reasons why music is so engaging for our students. It is my pleasure to introduce the combined beginning bands of Martin Larby and Sandstone Middle Schools as they perform 10 to the Power under the direction of Mr. Christian Motta.
Thank you.
fall, the marching band represented HHS at four marching band competitions in Oregon and Washington, making it to finals in all four competitions. The jazz bands traveled to the University of Idaho to participate in the Lionel Hampton Jazz Festival, with Jazz 1 receiving a superior mark. During the winter months, many students in the program spent countless hours supporting the culture here at HHS through their participation in the basketball pep band and our winter musical, Beauty and the Beast. I'm also excited to announce that the band program has been nominated to be one of five bands representing the state of Oregon in the 2023 Independence Day Parade in Washington, D.C.
Thank you. All right, my name is Dan Allen. If you don't know me, I'm the band teacher at Sandstone Middle School. And before we do our last tune, a couple thank yous that we want to give out. First and foremost to our MC tonight, Dr. Mooney. A round of applause. We'd also like to take this opportunity to thank our building and the district-wide administration, Mr. Spoo, Ms. Monica Mills, Mrs. Roberts, as well as all of the district's office for helping out with everything you see here and everything into our programs all year long. The administration of the building. A huge thank you to the Hermiston School District's maintenance department, who were out in panel trucks at 6 o'clock yesterday morning, going around collecting all of this gear from all the different schools, bringing it over here. Also, the Hermiston High School custodial staff, who were in charge, set up here, getting the mats down, huge thing. We need to thank our colleagues, for myself, the Sandstone staff, Marvin, the high school. This takes a lot of cooperation to pull off, and we're having to pull kids out of classes and come over for combined rehearsals. And so for all the staff, all the buildings, we are tremendously thank you. We'd also like to thank, I know I've seen at least three of the five, but our elementary school music teachers in the Hermiston School District. Mike Kellison's here. Go ahead and stand up if you're here. I saw Rachel Dollar. Jennifer Garfield. Johnny Cox is down here. And then Robin Roniger. Our penultimate thank you goes to you, the parents. We know it's a bit of a sacrifice. Especially to try to get here by 6 o'clock on a work day. I know that there's things behind the scenes, sacrifices that have to be made, schedules that need time. We know that, and we appreciate you. Thank you so much. And lastly, we would like to thank these students. They put in tremendously hard work the past 2 years on the band side of things. It's been a grind, and it's been difficult, and the kids have stuck with it, and they have persevered, and we're very, very proud of them. A round of applause, please, for our students. And before I hand the microphone back, just because it's a little bit different this year, we've had to split this up into a band program and a choir program separately. So after this next tune, the band portion will be done. The high school band's gonna stay put. The middle schoolers, we're gonna clear out and make room for the choir parents coming in. So, middle schoolers, if you're sitting in a chair with silver legs, take that out those doors and put it under the green sign to your right. I'll be out there and I'll direct traffic. Everything else can stay in here for now, unless it's a chair with silver legs. That goes out. The students will go back to the band room and collect their instruments. Parents, if you just stay here and wait for them outside the door, then we can avoid some log jams. Thank you so much.
One of the great things about this Hermiston School District Secondary Music Festival is that students from grades 6 through 12 have the opportunity to perform together and to see and hear where their musical endeavors can take them. It is now my pleasure to introduce the combined Hermiston School District bands as they perform Thrill Ride under the direction of Mr. Sean McClenahan, Mr. Dan Allen, and Mr. Christian Fun.
Thank you.
All right, we are at the point where we're ready to transition, but before you go, a few instructions. So we're going to get ready for choir. If you have a student participating in the next concert, please feel free to stay seated. If you have a student leaving, you can exit out the doors on the west side of the gym toward the tennis court and meet students out front. That will allow students who are coming in for the choir concert to enter through the east doors. Thank you for joining us this evening and have a great evening.
Good job, Julian! Woo! Good job, Tracy Lacey! Yeah, good job, Tracy Lacey!
Thank you. Thank you.
entire program in HHS continues to steamroll onward under the direction of Jordan Bedrose-Russ. This program currently offers four rigorous vocal ensembles where students can expand upon the fundamentals that they learned in their earlier studies. Over the last few years, the Hermiston Choirs have continued to find success in their performances, even through online schooling and COVID performance restrictions. During distance learning, the Hermiston Choirs took on and created several virtual choir videos. These virtual choir videos required students to independently learn their parts, record an audio of their singing, and record a video, all from their homes. These videos and audio recordings were then combined and edited to bring the choral pieces together and complete the songs in multiple part harmonies. With this, the Hermiston Chamber Choir combined with the Milton Free Water Chorus, Crimson and Black, to sing City Called Heaven. This choir recording was featured on the local news station, KNDU. This last winter, Hermiston High School choirs were the only high school to be featured at the Oregon State Capitol for the holidays, with a poster board of photos and a lovely write-up of the Hermiston Choir program. Recordings of several Hermiston Choir performances were also played on a television in the lobby at the state capitol. This past fall, Hermiston Choirs attended the Oregon State University Choir Festival, Festival of Voices, where over 500 choir students from all over the state came together to learn and perform several pieces, under the direction of the Oregon State University Choral Directors, Dr. Stephen Zilke and Dr. Sandra Beck. Each of the Hermiston Choirs were asked to perform at the beginning of the festival concert, acknowledging the good reputation, hard work, and beautiful music the Hermiston Choirs continue to uphold. At the beginning of March, all of the Hermiston High School Choirs competed for adjudication against the other local schools in front of three judges at the Oregon District 6 Choral Festival in LeGrand. All four Hermiston ensembles received superior scores and performed wonderfully. Let's listen to our exceptional high school choir program at work with their performance of Wongle under the direction of Mrs. Deborah Ritten.
Thank you.
pursuit of music thinking. Studies show that students who participate in ensemble music experience a wide range of neurological, psychological, and physiological benefits, including increased memory, increased coordination, heightened levels of empathy, as well as highly developed levels of creative thinking, spatial intelligence, self-confidence, teamwork, and risk-taking. We are pleased to have so many students enrolled in musical ensembles within the Hermiston School District and are excited to show off all their hard work. Under the direction of Stacy Cooley, the choir programs at Mark Malarkey Middle School and Sandstone Middle School provide a strong musical foundation for younger students to develop their musicianship through the preparation and performance of choral music. These students must learn an extraordinary amount of ear training in order to read music. Unlike instrumentalists, there are no keys or buttons to help them find certain pitches. They must train themselves to hear the intervals and relationships between notes in their mind so that they can sing a printed piece of music. Tonight, the combined choirs of Armand Larby and Sandstone Middle Schools will be performing Natso Nu Yawa, directed by Stacy Cooley and accompanied by Mrs. Margaret Wetterly on piano.
Thank you.
let's now listen to all of the Hermiston School District Choir students sing together as they perform "Sisi Ni Mo Ya" under the direction of Stacy Cooley, accompanied by Mrs. Margaret Wetterly.
Thank you.
right. I'm Dan Allen. I'm the band teacher at Sandstone Middle School. I've been asked to do a couple of thank yous here before we have our finale. The first person we need to thank tonight's MC, Dr. Mooney, superintendent of the Hermiston School District. We'd like to thank the administration at our buildings, the two middle schools and the high school, as well as at the Hermiston School District office for all of their help and their support tonight and throughout the whole year. For the guys who are out in the panel trucks at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, or yesterday morning, they'll be out again at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, just moving all the equipment from school to school. The Hermiston School District Maintenance Department, thank you very much. We'd like to thank the Hermiston High School custodial staff for getting this gym prepped. They'll clean it when we leave. For all their hard work to make this event happen, the Hermiston High School custodians. A big thank you for all of our colleagues, the teachers at Sandstone Middle School, Armin Larby, Hermiston High School. To pull this off, it requires pulling kids out of class for combined rehearsals. There's a lot of sacrifices that are made. We'd like to thank all of our colleagues, our staff at the three schools. Donna's here, Mike's here, Jennifer's here. Thank you so much for the work that you do before we ever even see the kids. We'd like to thank you, the parents. We know that it's a huge sacrifice to have involved kids, but it's a worthwhile sacrifice. But that doesn't mean that it's easy. And we know that getting here on a Thursday night and just jumping through all the hoops that you need to jump through as a parent to get your kids to everywhere that they need to be, we're sincerely thankful. Thank you so much. And lastly, we would like to thank our fabulous students. It has been a long 2 years in the music program, but these kids have had perseverance. They've stuck with it. They've done what needed to be done, even when it wasn't easy and even when it wasn't necessarily the most fun. So we're very proud of our students. We're very glad to be back with you in person. And I will turn it back to Dr. Mooney.
Sean McClenahan. If you served in the military, please stand when you hear your armed services march to be recognized. The lyrics for each song will be projected on the screen to the side of the band. Everyone is welcome to join in.
Thank you.
How about a round of applause for all of us? Thank you again for sharing this evening's performance and your support of Hermiston School District and our music programs. Have a fabulous evening.
Back in the Stone Age.
For sure. Keller, it's good to see you.
Nice to see you. it's hard to email dead, like, unless you catch me on the back, because my phone is doing so much.
Yeah, great.
Thank you. Thank you.